my name's Philip, and I live in a medieval house right next to Durham Cathedral. Your view from the back is spectacular because it looks out onto the Durham Cathedral. People who come and stay in the house say you've probably got one of the best views in England. You know, 720,000 visitors come every year. Sometimes when you open the front door, you're immediately in the camera shot. But, you know, behind your front door, that's our space, isn't it? Once you're used to it, that's fine. But if people want to look through the window and see me naked, well, good luck to them.
For very long, about a month or so. From 2013 onwards, I didn't really have a home. I was stretching from place to place, not knowing where I'd be next. The first night I was homeless, I thought, oh, I'll be fine, I'll sleep somewhere safe and I'll be okay. I ended up getting robbed and someone took my phone. They took all the belongings I had with me. I felt really scared and shaken up afterwards. And since then, I didn't really sleep when I was on the streets. When I got a phone call from Dana Valley telling me that I'd gotten a flat and that I could move in, I collapsed to the floor and I cried my eyes out. My mum helped me get a fridge and my dad's helped me with the washer and the loads have really gone into the wood to make it all. I'll go straight into the room and sit down on my own couch and it feels great to know that I can just sit down on my couch.
So we have decorated the house of bright and bold colours.
The theme throughout the whole house is basically purple and black because I'm into that sort of gothic thing.
One feature that I did put back is I restored the railings around my house that were taken down in the war.
When one of the builders went up into the attic, we were downstairs. We heard an enormous bang.
And then when I learned about the fee that I changed my first room's decoration, yeah, quite a bit.
I do want to put some just more fibre wallpaper on just to change the room a bit. Just to make it a bit more different, a bit more me.
If I see a rainbow.
weeks ago, actually, when we had some bad storms and a lot of thunder and lightning and hail, there was a beautiful rainbow which kind of seemed to land in the field right outside of our house. And to me, that's a very beautiful image, something that makes me very happy.
When we are sitting outside in the garden, it's a nice sight to see the parachutes coming down. At first you hear the screams and the cries, and then you see the canopies open and the people falling down from the sky.
The grandchildren are really fantastic. Yeah. They do, because they just float and they float like angels. I remember when I was a little kid, all the doors would be open all the time. Having always felt safe and secure in my home because we were there when I was about 8. They came in through the front door, ransacked the bottom of the house. I didn't even wake up. And then they just left. That had a big effect on us. I kind of felt vulnerable in my own home.
I've been a victim of crime for several times, and I bought myself a CCTV camera to protect me, and I bought an alarm. I pay for it. So that makes me feel safe again.
Everybody's dancing in the moonlight, yeah. finished school on the Friday night, I was in the pit on the Sunday night. And I couldn't stand it.
The end of the mines was the end of community life.
The mining industry went deeper than work and jobs. It was a culture, it was a language, it was a way of life.
It devastated the community because it was the hope. It was the centre of the community, the mine.
At one time, you could go out the door and get a job today, and pack it in there one tomorrow. It doesn't work that way no more. And a lot of people giving up hope.
And now as people are moving in from outside areas, it's just a question of building the community again.
But you can't live on yesterday's. You've got to live on today. You have. You all club together. You all get on with it. And you survive.
Our house was built in the late 1700s.
I've lived in Calvary Durham for 25 years.
Or St. John lived with me.
It's a Georgian townhouse.
Terrace Street.
I'm in the top floor.
Dates from the medieval period.
Built of random stone and rubble.
We've got flowers and everything on our side.
And it is now full of art from top to bottom.
It's comfortable. It's just a nice size. Lovely view. Perfect for me, but not for anyone else. It's what we called home and lived here for a year and a half.
I fell in love with it from the minute I walked into it.
A millionaire couldn't buy it. It's great.